Now look at what we saw coming down here. People can still come down here, but it's okay putting this here. Yeah. Hopefully that there should stop them. But it's the other entrance that bothers me. We got them blocked off here. That car that we saw must have been them. Come on, you two. Come on, Elvis. Yeah, that car that I saw must have been the landowner. Hang on. I'll just, because I've got poo cack. Right. Got a board of this. And come on then, got a board of this. Come on then. Yes, Sheba, what is it? Something different, isn't it? Different to investigate. It's starting to go rotten. I can smell the sweetness of that. Like a horrible, soury, sweety smell. Horrible. Yeah. That's what that stone was there before. It was right there. And then it got moved down here somewhere, just where that ball patch is there. Next thing you know, it's over there. So I don't know who moved it, but yeah, they've cleared some of the. It doesn't look as though they cleared the rubbish, just moved it out the way by the looks. No, hang on. Or have they cleared some of it? They have cleared some of it by the looks. But look at the bloody. Do you know that's a big ball patch there? Look at him, look at. Yeah, it looks like they cleared some of it. But not all of it, but it looks. That must have been the landowner that I saw. I wonder how much it cost them to get this done. Right then, Shebes and Horace. Come on then. Come on, Sheba. Come on then. Ready? Come on, you two. Oh, there was a butterfly there. Come on, Sheba. Sheba. That must have been either done last night or, because I came over here after 8 o'clock and the rubbish was still there, so it might have either been done late or first thing this morning. I assume it would have been done first thing this morning. Yeah. Like I say, there's that entrance just down there. That there. It can block people from going down onto the field there, but it can't over there. That's the thing. Because that's, like I say, that entrance over there. It's the other way. Other way onto this field. And it's actually, believe it or not, there's a gate down there. But the gate's been pulled off. Oh, let's have a see. There's another poo cack. I've already got two lots of poo cack here. I'll pick this one if it's right on there. Oh, wasn't even worth doing. Ah, the grass is starting to grow, like, when you see it. When I was filming last night, I just turned the camera off, and Horace chased a rabbit, a big rabbit, out the field just behind me. Yeah, he did. Now this is going to sound a bit muffled. There you go, two doggies. Waiting for me, aren't you? Yeah. So things do happen over here. Bit of excitement. Like I said before, I think it was last year, there was this four-wheel drive. Actually, I was sort of over there somewhere, and I saw this four-wheel drive come right across the field. And I thought, where the hell has that come from? I didn't see it when I was up here, so it might have been coming down the path, right, or the old railway line, yeah, and went right across that field. Now, there's nothing of interest over there, Sheba, no birdies. Yeah. Look. Yeah, what's Horace doing, Sheba? Yeah, what's Horace doing? He's been a nana, isn't he? He's been a nana. Yeah. Yeah, Andy has an appointment tomorrow. The thing is, unfortunately, he's going to have to get yourself out of bed to go to it, because it's at the hospital. And it's one of these important ones as well. That's something to do with his bowel. So, he's going to have to get yourself up and ready. I'm just trying to spin the flip. That's it. Oops, there you go. Yeah, he has an appointment tomorrow. He had a letter arrived, I think it's Friday now. Third? Thing is, he's got the same person next week. Yeah, so he's going to be very busy, because for the next few weeks he's going to be hospital appointments. So the thing is, it's been him being well enough to actually get out of bed, you know. That's the thing. That's the only thing. Thing is, Andy's been in that frame of mind, yeah, that he feels he's been, how can I put it, because his mum is in the home, he thinks that he's the one to blame, and he had nothing to do with that at all. It was with his younger brother and sister, and also we were told that it had something to do with the doctor advising that she would go, for her to go on home, because her condition was getting worse. Alzheimer's never gets better, you know. I gets worse, steadily worse. And they would advise her to put in a home, have a doctor, apparently. And then, like I say, Andy thinks that he's to blame, and he had nothing to do with it at all. In fact, he knew nothing about it till Lash put her in the home. The thing is, there's like a complicated land for the house, but that has got something to do with Dave. Is your other brother, but if anybody knows, if you need medical care and you own your home property, that the value of it goes towards the cost of the medical care, and that's the legal wrangle with it. So unfortunately the house, the inheritance is gone, you know, the inheritance. So I was lucky, right, changing the subject, that me mum and me dad, they never owned their own property. So I was lucky in that sense that we didn't have medical bills to pay for, because me mum, she died in hospital, and so did me dad. They didn't own anything, everything was rented. So when my mum died, my dad took over the residence. Well, I think it was in what was council house. So my dad took over. Yeah. And when my dad died, they'd actually moved to the council property. Council property was going to be redeveloped, knocked down, which it was. The street name's changed, but my dad knew that, and so he ended up moving. Yeah. And I went into private council housing. Well, it's not council, private housing actually. It's not council housing. When you got married. It'll be coming up for 5 years when my dad passed away. Yeah, he died in the end of August. It'll be coming up for 5 years. It seems like a long time, but it seems like it was yesterday, you know. But the only thing that bothered me about the entire thing was the fact that when my dad died, nobody phoned me, because I still had my mobile phone, and I never changed the number, so that's it. And nobody phoned me, so I had no idea that my dad was in hospital. No idea. I had a phone call about 5 o'clock from my brother, and he assumed that I knew, and I didn't. The thing is, she sent me a message on Facebook, and at the time I wasn't spending a lot of time on the computer. And And I just never got to see my dad, because while I was on the phone, my dad passed away. So I never got to see him. And that was the only thing that bothered me. It really is, and it still does bother me. Because if I knew, right, if she phoned me and I knew he was in hospital, yeah, I would have went to see him straight away. But no, she didn't. She phoned our Jason, apparently, and he lives in bloody Doncaster. So she never kept me telephone number. Where's the doggies? Right, I'm going to go. Here they are. There's one. And the other one is down there. Two and then two, Lou, for now.